Everybody. So I was on Facebook the other day, and I am a part of a group that I think it's carnivore, like people who just eat meat. A friend of mine, he has the whole thing going over there on Facebook. And in this group, it was very interesting that someone commented and said, "You know what? I'm disturbed by the number of people in here who believe in the flat earth." Now, I don't comment in that group. I just look to see what they're talking about. And when she made that comment, it was like, I don't know, it was just a whole storm, in there with other people saying, "Well, why do you care? This is a carnivore group. Who cares about the flat earth?" And other flat earthers who were in there, making their argument for there being a flat earth. So that same day, my friend and I were talking about, actually, we watched a documentary, and there was a guy, I'll never get his name, but he's like a really radical Christian and, Republican and all that. So after I saw the documentary, I went ahead and I joined his Facebook group, and I'm part of other Facebook groups too, like a Hindu group. I'm part of what is it? A little per pe people who have people who are little people or have children who are little people. So there are a lot of groups I'm a part of where I do not fit the description. Okay. However, I'm part of those groups because I want to see what these folks are talking about because I don't have these perspectives that they have. So I want to see what their perspective is. I want to kind of see the world through their eyes. So, but in doing that, what I'm noticing with them and with me is that we're under a lot of pressure to be. Now you fill in the blank after be, okay? Whatever it is, you are, we're under pressure to be that. However, we're also under pressure just to be. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's a lot of, now we know to be a mom, all the labels you have, a mom, a dad, a non-dualist, a preacher, a child, a taxpayer, whatever the hell. But forget about all that. Before we get to those labels, the pressure to be, that's a lot. Isn't that a lot of pressure? Tell the truth now. Because it's something that should be effortless, right? Why you gotta work? Why you under pressure to be? And I say in my book, Firing God, how I was like, damn, what the heck? Why is this so hard? All I'm trying to do is live. Why the hell is it so hard? The birds seem to be having a grand old time, They ain't got no issues. But Cheryl, I'm struggling down here just to be, and the thing is that I don't have to, okay? Cheryl, there's too many cooks in the kitchen now. Like, what are you doing? Okay, so what does that actually mean? What does it mean when I'm working, struggling? I mean, breaking sweats, muscle failure. Trying to be, okay, and that's when all those other things come into play. Be a woman and a mom and black and 5 feet 5 and 200 pounds, trying to be smart and all that other stuff, child. All right, so there's a song out right now by Ari Lennox, okay? It's called Pressure. Okay. And I heard this song and I'm like, damn it, that's exactly what the hell is going on here. Okay. We had a lot of pressure. All right. But it doesn't have to be that way. It can be that way. And it's okay if it's that way. If you feel pressured to be, then feel pressured to be. But the idea is that it's not necessary. All that struggling and stuff. It's not necessary, but it's not right or wrong.
Get it, don't be timid when you ain't a plotter. Love upon it.